Hi, my name is Ronnie Datta, and today we're going to talk about the Nanda Dynasty on Let's Talk About Bharat. The Nanda Dynasty ruled in the northern part of the Indian subcontinent during the 4th century BC. The Nandas overthrew the Shishunaga dynasty in the Magadha region of eastern India and expanded their empire to include a larger part of northern India. Both Indian and Greco-Roman traditions characterize the dynasty's founder of low birth. According to Greek historian Diodorus, Porus told Alexander that the contemporary Nanda king was thought to be the son of a barber. The Jain tradition, as recorded in the Avashayaka Sutra and Parishthita Parvan, corroborates the Greco-Roman account stating that the first Nanda king was a son of a barber and the mother of the first Nanda king was also a courtesan. The Buddhist, Jain and Puranic traditions all state that there were 9 Nanda kings, but the sources differ considerably on the names of these kings. According to the Puranic tradition, the dynasty's founder was Mahapadma. The Matsya Purana assigns him an incredibly long reign of 88 years, while the Vayu Purana mentions the length of his reign as only 28 years. The Puranas further state that Mahapadma's 8 sons ruled in succession after him for a total of 12 years, but name only one of these sons, Sukalpa. According to the Sri Lankan Buddhist text, Mahavamsa, there were 9 Nanda kings. They were brothers who ruled in succession for a total of 22 years. These 9 kings were Ugrasena, Panduka, Pandugati, Bhutapala, Rashtrapala, Govishanaka, Dasa Siddhaka, Kaivarta, and Dhana. The Nanda capital was located at Pataliputra near present-day Patna in the Magadha region of eastern India. This is confirmed by the Buddhist and Jain traditions as well as the Sanskrit play Mudrarakshasa. The Nanda Empire appears to have stretched from present-day Punjab in the west to Odisha in the east. The Nanda kings appear to have strengthened the Magadha kingdom ruled by the Haryanka and Shishunaga predecessors, creating the first great empire of northern India in the process. The Puranas describe the Nanda king as Ikarat or single ruler, which suggests that the Nanda empire was an integrated monarchy rather than a group of virtually independent feudal states. Several historical sources refer to the great wealth of the Nandas. According to the Mahavamsa, the last Nanda king was a treasure holder and amassed wealth worth 80 kotis or 800 million. He buried these treasures in the bed of the Ganges River. He acquired further wealth by levying taxes on all sorts of objects, including skins, gums, trees, and stones. Alexander the Great invaded northwestern India at the time of the last Nanda king, Dhanananda. In the summer of 326 BC, Alexander's army reached the Bees River, beyond which the Nanda territory was located. Alexander learned that the Nanda force included 200,000 infantry, 80,000 cavalry, 6,000 elephants, and 8,000 chariots. But the Nanda army did not have the opportunity to face Alexander, whose soldiers mutinied at the Bees River, refusing to go any further in the east. Alexander's soldiers had started to agitate to return to their homeland, and the stiff resistance that they had met in northwestern India had demoralized them. They mutinied when faced with the prospect of facing the powerful Nanda army, forcing Alexander to withdraw from India. Ancient texts suggest that the Nandas were unpopular among their subjects because of the low status birth, their excessive taxation, and the general misconduct. The last Nanda king was overthrown by Chandragupta Maurya, the founder of the Maurya Empire, and the latter's mentor, Chanakya. I hope you like this video about the Nanda dynasty, and if you did, please share it with your friends and family. Subscribe to MyNation and keep watching. Let's talk about Bharat.